You are well read, intelligent and serious minded. You and Keshav were two brothers. Like Gaur and Nitai, you have had enough lecturing, discussions, quarrels and disputes. Are you interested in these things anymore? Gather your whole mind and concentrate it on God. Just jump into God.
Yes, sir. There is no doubt about that. This clearly is my duty now. But I am doing all this to preserve Keshav's name.
You say you're doing all this to keep his name alive. But after some time, this spirit will not last. Listen to a story. A person had his own house on the top of a hill. It was small, thatched house. He had labored hard to build it. After a few days, there was a terrible storm. The house began to shake. The man became very worried as to how to save it. He said, "Open again, the God of Wind. Please don't destroy my house." But the God of Wind turned a deaf ear to his words. The house began to shake violently. Then he remembered that Hanuman was the son of Pavandev. As soon as this thought entered his mind, he cried out, "Oh Father, don't destroy this house. It is Hanuman's house. I beseech you." But the house still shook. Who would listen to him? When he repeated, "Hanuman's house, Hanuman's house," so many times, and nothing happened, he began to say, "Father, it is Lakshman's house. It is the house of Lakshman." This too carried no weight. Then he began to call out, "Father, it is Ram's house. It is Ram's. I say, Father, don't wreck it. I beseech you." Even now, nothing happened. The house began to collapse. The question now was how to save his own life. Running out of the house, the man cried, "It is the devil's own house." You don't have to save Keshav's name. Know that everything happens by the will of God. It was there by God's will, and it is coming to an end by His will. What can you do? Now your duty is simply to give your whole mind to God, to dive deep into His ocean of love.